So Rav is one of those times we're trying to do something kind of different from what's typically done in the world of brewing and trying to play with a new and different approach to flavors. What's accepted as a pumpkin beer largely in brewing is beers that either do or don't contain pumpkin that are then spiced with pumpkins, pumpkin pie spice. So your mace, cinnamon, clove, allspice, nutmeg. And those are well done, so we see no reason for us to do those. But we like the idea of, a farm harvest time kind of autumnal beer. So we're always looking to play with gourds in a different way. This time we deconstructed a dish I had on my honeymoon, which was a Luna de Miele moon ravioli that was stuffed with pumpkin and butternut squash, and then it was served in a brown butter and sage sauce. And at the table, they grated on a cheese grater a biscotti cookie, so it had like this fennel crunch on it. So in the long run, we knew we wanted to let the butternut squash show, and it shows in that kind of drying mouthfeel of an unsweetened gourd. And then we dress that up with the notes of fennel, the richness of the butter, and some of the sage. And it's this really kind of fun, it speaks to autumn, it's a spicy gourd squash beer without being pumpkin pie beer again. And we love it. We put it together. We did some crowned capped growlers. Every now and then, if we do a beer that isn't dependent on its hops for flavors and we're comfortable with the idea of aging it, we'll put some beer into our half growlers and cap them and wax them so that if you're somebody that wants to see it mature, you have, time to do that. We'll put it out this Sunday in the tasting room, noon to 5. Like I said, there'll be some limits and we'll just come out and see what people think of it. But altogether, I really like the beer now that it's the days right now are in the 60s, and it's a great beer for that kind of sunset around 6:37 in a fall day.